Good afternoon.
Am I deaf or you're not speaking? Good afternoon. I know you are hungry and maybe lunch is waiting, but yes, we are talking on some serious subject. So maybe we'll start with a new word for those who don't know. So can we together say VENDA? So you have just told me you don't want lunch. Have you? Okay, because VENDA in our language means no. And that is what the project is all about, where we encourage children to say no, not just to drugs, but there is a culture around here. For example, let's say there is a party happening at home and the parents or the father is drinking, and tendency is to ask the child to get the glass or the ice or the water. So we tell or we encourage our children to start saying no there itself. Saying, Daddy, if you want to drink, it is your choice, but I will not bring a glass for you. So that is what Project VENDA is all about. Not just working with children who are addicted to drugs. Because in our little experience, you know, we live in a very confused world. I don't know if you realize. We have fat people who want to become thin, and thin people who want to become fat. You have tall people who want to become short, and short people where everything possible to become tall. You have fair people sitting in the sun to become dark, and dark people putting all possible creams to become fair. You have people in, you have countries where they don't have clothes, they wear clothes, and in countries where they have plenty of clothes, they throw away the clothes that they have. And in this confusion, our children have to grow. And maybe that is where you and I play a very important role. When I stand here, I know I am no one to speak, because some of your experience, like for example, Mr. Johnson, your experience is actually more than my age. Now, but just to share what we do. Before that, I don't know if you're aware, but we have an online streaming happening. And more than the people over here, there are 500 people actually watching us online. Okay, so if you want to share the link with your friends, you can share. And to our friends watching us online, if you want to communicate anything to us, you want to send us a message, you can note the email over here, asiaforum2019@fourthwayfoundation.org, and we will respond to you. So actually, this conference, as of now, we have around 130 here and almost 500 watching online. So that is the... Maybe by afternoon, I'll tell you from which countries and how many countries are also watching us online. Let me start this maybe 5 to 10 minutes by sharing some experiences that I have seen in the social sector. Okay, I'm not talking about drugs. I'm not talking about anything else, but some experiences. And I have seen four dimensions of work in the social sector. It's just to lighten the mood, and maybe you can identify which category or which dimension you or your civil society or your government works. The first dimension, everything comes with a video, so I would like you to pay close attention to what is happening on screen. I don't know if you realize, this is called door delivery. Okay? You have the deer running around and running around and running around, finally landing right in front, or falling right in front of where it, I don't know, where it should not be going. And there, I have seen a lot of people in social sector doing this, running around and running around and running around, and after maybe a couple of years, nowhere to be seen. Did they do a lot of work? They did. Did they run around a lot? They did. But at the end of the time, I don't know, you would not see them. I don't know, if you are like that, you would not be here, right? So at least we don't belong to this category. Second is a little more interesting category, the dimension two. So please watch the video for a few seconds. I call this dimension drag on. I don't know if you have seen people like this. Oh, somehow there is a problem. Let us do something. And the whole activity that they do is a big burden. And this not only destroys themselves. The first dimension only destroys themselves. But this dimension destroys the organization they are with. And in management, you often say the best way to destroy an organization is to get into leadership and do nothing. If you do something bad, people will oppose. If you do nothing, then nobody can do anything. The third dimension is, maybe I've seen a lot of organizations like this, so watch very carefully, please. called the oh my God dimension. I'm sure you have this experience in your life. You have this type of, you have seen this type of, you know, from far or you know from many long ago that an issue is happening or an issue is going to come. One example can be climate change by now. You know, for many years ago, we knew something is going to happen, something drastic has to be done, but we were very quiet until the last moment we do nothing. And maybe the issue on drugs is something like that. If we don't act now, then we will reach somewhere over here. Now, did the child get saved or not? I don't know. But the child, even if the child is saved, the child is saved with a lot of injuries. Okay, so this is a dimension where you don't only destroy your organization, you destroy people around you. And the fourth dimension. Maybe a lot of people over here will belong to this dimension, so please spend a few seconds watching this. See this brother of this little girl coming up after his treatment for cancer, and he lost all his hair. And this young child, sister of this boy, very joyfully living up or giving up everything she had. Was she sad at any moment? If you watch the video, was she sad at any moment? No, her parents were at. And when they saw her, they were surprised, what is this child doing? But she did it so joyfully. She did it with so much of happiness. Whether it is benefiting or not is not her concern. She is trying to do what she thinks is right. And I believe most of us in this hall belong to this. You have taken so much of effort. You have taken so much of time, so much of money, so much of all your resources to do what we are doing. So before we continue, can you just look at the person next to you and say, well done. Don't worry. Maybe next couple of minutes on what Project VENDA is all about. When we started Project VENDA, Fourth Way Foundation, I'll talk on the last day. When we started Project VENDA, we had six key things in mind. And these are the six key things around which our projects revolve. We identify the problem. We did a research on the problem. Our job is to create a model, implement it, monitor it, and hand it over to the government, because we know as a civil society, our reach is not very long. The government has immense reach. We can maybe impact a few cities, maybe even a state. But if a country like India has to be impacted, the government has to take up the model. And that is what is there in our mind. So maybe we say that we will run a model for 5 years. And every time we do a project, we say that 10 years from starting the project, we will be jobless. You know, because somebody else will actually take up the project and continue and run the project. We don't want to be eternally doing the project that we are doing. If in 10 years or 15 years we are not able to address the issue, then there is something that we are not doing right. Okay, so after 15 years, maybe when you come to Kerala, you might not hear Diana and me doing Project VENDA. It would be someone else. Maybe the state government would be running Project VENDA. And that is the vision or the dream that we have. Second, we have interventions at various levels. One is we do trainings in school. We have community interventions. We have alternate pursuits. Maybe one of the biggest successes of Project VENDA is alternate pursuit. You know, two of our simple boys who were playing football with what we call Pepsi bottles and all. They represented India in the Homeless World Cup, and they got, India won the Dragon Cup. And for us, we always share with great pride, more than winning the Dragon Cup, these two boys who were journeying with us got the award for fair play. And kids coming back with this background, getting a fair play award is something tremendous for us. So we always, We tell them, you winning the cup is not important for us, but you getting fair play award is very important for us. Then we do a lot of research. And finally, we influence policy change. And maybe this conference on one level is about influencing policy change. In the schools, what do we do? The details of the training I will share a little later on. But we have realized that Entering a community is easy through the schools. We do two important things in the school. First and foremost, we engage with children so they can make informed choices. Second very important thing, we work with children to help them understand the implication of their choices. Because very often our children don't know the implication of their choices. In our experience, most of the kids who fall prey to substance abuse either start as experiment or they are forced by their peers. And very few of them actually go and say that I want to be drugged. They are either forced by their friends or they start as an experiment. So we work in the schools where we teach them what choices are and how important these choices are and how maybe a lasting impact these choices have in their life. And secondly, for us, working in the community or the community is the only solution to this problem. Unless and until all of us hold our hands together, we do not see a solution to this problem, especially in reducing the demand. Because we have examples and we will share. For example, in a community that we work, today if a stranger comes to that community, the community people will go and ask. If that person is behaving suspicious, they will go and ask, why are you here? What is the reason? Why are you standing outside the school when the school is, when children are going back home, you know? Unless and until that happens, I don't know if we can actually have a lasting result for this. Because you and I, after some time, will go and have to go. The community has to take this mantle upon themselves. And why the community? Because two important things we always believe. We build a culture of taking ownership of the child's problem and not hold the child alone responsible. Sometimes what happens in our culture is, if anything bad or wrong happens to the child, we think the child is responsible. And long back, I remember one person telling me, Sisi, have you ever noticed that we teach our children good manners by bad manners? I said, what do you mean? He said, how do you tell your kids to keep quiet? I shout. So I'm actually teaching good manners with bad manners. So maybe just putting it in a different way. Because we as a community need to be held accountable if our children do not know how to make responsible choices. If they are not making the right choices, it is not just our kids' problem. It is all our problem. We have not been with them or helped them or encouraged them to make the right choices. And that is what we believe at Project VENDA. We work with the age group from 3 to 20. We only work with youngsters. And like I said in the beginning, our average age is 28 years. And maybe that is why young people, when we do training for school children, I also don't take trainings. Because they look up to me as some big outsider coming and talking. But when an elder brother, who is just a few years, maybe older to them, stand and talk to them, all the ears are open. Their senses are open. And that is what Project VENDA does. So maybe I just want to summarize with what we always say. Together we can change the story. Only together can we change the story. All of us working independently, we can make small, significant, maybe changes in the story. But if the story has to change completely, we have to hold our hands and do it together. So together, let's join as we shout. As we shout. Thank you and God bless.